To my right, you can see the pristine Hawaiian atmosphere, beautiful blue sky and scattered meteorologic clouds. But as we pan over, then we see the rising volcanic gas from Halemaumau. And this is primarily sulfur dioxide and then steam in this case. Coming out of the vent, roughly 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit, the gas rises at thermal buoyancy until it equilibrates with the surrounding air, the same temperature. And then we bend over and become entrained with the wind patterns. The SO2, or the sulfur dioxide gas, reacts with the atmosphere to form sulfate aerosols. And these are very dangerous to human health, both from breathing and also form corrosive acids. This noxious mixture is called volcanic smog, or VOG. Right now, the VOG models are initialized by point sources, but we can measure the two-dimensional distribution of sulfur dioxide at the plume source from the satellites and the aircraft through our remote sensing, which then helps make more accurate estimates of how it will be dispersed. So we're hoping to improve these volcanic forecast models. On the ground, we're making measurements to help to validate or collaborate the data we get from the aircraft.
What I like about the landscapes on volcanoes is the strange shapes, forms, colors of lava flows, of ash flows, of all these different volcanic surfaces that very slowly get re-inhabited by vegetation. It's an interesting thing to see.
I grew up on an island volcano in Greece, an extinct volcano, not a very active volcano. But I had the chance many years later in graduate school then to come along on a trip to the Philippines a few years after Mount Pinatubo had erupted. And what I saw was the human impact, the human factor of how volcanic eruptions affect livelihoods of people. That is something that had a profound impact on me, that made it basically my life's mission to keep working on improving the methods that help us understand how volcanoes work, and to be able to better forecast how and when eruptions occur. We're downwind of the plume source by a few miles. By this point, some of the gas has converted into aerosols, and we're measuring the product of that conversion here. The measurements we do here are in most cases timed with the overpasses of the AR2 aircraft. So once we are back at our computers and look at this imaging data, we can then use our measurements from the ground here to improve the gas retrievals and aerosol retrievals we do on the imagery data.
We're measuring with two techniques. One is a sun photometer, and we're measuring how the sunlight shining through the plume is scattered by the particles. The other is an instrument called the fly spec, which measures ultraviolet radiation, and we're seeing the absorption of the UV radiation by the actual gas in the plume. We are one of several teams that are looking at the volcano in this HyspIRI preparatory mission. We have another team looking at the actual molten material. We have another team coming in to make in situ measurements of the concentrations of the gas. And there's another team that's measuring the impact of the volcanic gas on vegetation in the area.
Using the ground-based instrument, we have the highest spatial resolution. And then as we go higher up through the airborne and the satellite sensors, the spatial resolution is a lot poorer. And so we want to see if we can still pick out these characteristics of both the lava lake and the lava flows.
We're here to correct the data to make sure that what we see in space is what we actually see on the ground. The atmosphere is like looking at a lens, and we're right now characterizing that lens.
The great hope is that if and when the HyspIRI mission will be flying on a satellite platform, that we will be able to get very frequent measurements and re-measurements of these volcanic emissions, not only here in Hawaii, but around the world on all of the about 550 active volcanoes.
We can have a real impact on helping people to manage this risk if we can make the measurements and give them the information they need.